I'm very curious to see. Oh, wow. Yesterday you chided me for wishing to wait. Now you suggest an even longer delay. Perhaps the voices in your skull outright come to a consensus if you wish to be taken seriously. Good advice is flexible, changing with the moment of a changing with the moment. Besides, now we're agreeing yesterday. You today, you should be happy. You know, you we know you hate going in battle without overwhelming odds on your side. If you're so terrified of the challenge, why not wait for your reinforcements? You know what? They're going so fast. Oh my God, Iron Marshal, hello. Oh, well, nope.
That's four reports of avalanches in the mountains now. The Tearsmen can barely come past nine. They have neither the capacity nor the cause to close off the mountain passes. Either way, that leaves the second and fourth cohort trapped outside the valley.
He pounds his staff on the ground to punctuate his words. A large and imposing man to begin with. His profile is made larger by his hulking suit of armor that hums with mystic energy.
Or it's the work of your perfidious Earthshakers. Only a fool would not suspect a traitorous Archon of poisoning the mind of his students with sedition. We would have killed the Earthshakers Guild for their master's treachery. But I'm sure you have some perfectly valid reason for allowing them to live as your pawns.
The Archon of Secrets passes a scepter between his hands as he speaks, twirling a rod in hypnotic circles. Emerald luminescence seeps from the seams of his Archon seeps seeps blah. Seeps from the seams of the Archon's ragged red robes. The glow is most noticeable where his neck ought to be. His mask seems to float and spin, never pivoting or bending naturally. Okay.
Hey, watch yourself. When these two get going, you don't want to get between them.
Okay, let's remain silent.
I always know you've run out of things to say when you resort to mocking my vassals. If we are to speak of treachery, why is it that my scouts see the Scarlet Chorus warriors defecting back to the Vendrian Guard? Your fearsome reputation has gone flaccid, for it seems you cannot control your soldiers, or perhaps you simply choose not to.
Okay. Iron Marshal Enrios? My lords, the Fatebinder has arrived. The disfavored commander raises her voice, trying to get a little success over the Archons. Perhaps we could table this discussion and let our guests speak.
Speaking of strategic failures, who was it that insisted the valley would need only a token garrison? For some strange reason, we can't seem to recall which balding half-wit grossly underestimated the enemy. Thoughts?
The Archon of Secrets twirls his scepter in a twisting loop, his leather-wrapped hands flipping the heavy rod with an effortless flow. I'm gonna keep on remaining silent.
And I thought you had left agents within these Tearsmen when they surrendered. Either you failed to see this coming, or you knew and let it happen. Incompetent or in cahoots, either way, this mess has your filthy stink all over it.
The Archon of War lurches forward. His weight rested on his war maul as the blue luminescence, crackles around his armor.
We look forward to seeing you explain to Tunon why the Archon of War could not close the vice on this trivial little insurgency. When we are crowned the ruler of the Tears, we shall have this place renamed to Ashes Folly in your honor.
He tosses a scepter into the air, catching it as it descends back down. What's wrong with these people? Remain silent.
If I could trust the information I get from you and your conscripted mouth breathers, perhaps I'd order my cohorts around a bit more aggressively. But last time I trusted your all clear report, my troops failed to come home.
Oh, Ash, old boy. If you're going to have a little sob every time one of your nieces or nephews dies to the Tearsman, perhaps we should have Siren sing you some calming lullabies to help you cope with your grief.
Oh, Siren, okay, not Siren. The Archon flips his scepter around three times around, humming gleefully. Hold your tongue. I will not have you denigrate the honor of our fallen brethren. The commander's hand moves to the hilt of her blade, that the weapon stays sheathed. I'd be doing all of us a favor if I cracked open that excuse for a head. They bicker like children, do they not? The fifth eye's grating tenor pierces the tension in the tent, and all eyes land on the crimson spear. I meant only to say welcome to our guest, the Fatebinder. The armored retainer bows with rushed inelegance, and then rises to a salute. And not a moment too soon. Okay. Wow, interesting. Governor Krennis, long have we been honored by your iron, and now we are honored by your presence. I must apologize for my lords. Tempers run on high of late. Okay, I thought that was Graven Ash speaking for some reason. I don't know why. Probably because of this. Yeah. Let's apologize for the sudden entrance. I've traveled long to be here.
Ah, the Stormcaller. Conveniently late once more. Our eyes and ears tell us you come bearing an edict. The anticipation is killing us.
Yeah.
My soldiers tell me you helped Commander Drotus on your way through Edring. You honor the court with your selfless cooperation, for that is the sort of camaraderie that Kairos demands of us all.
On his last words, the Archon of War glares at the voices of Narat, furrowing his brow as he utters the word camaraderie. I require no thanks for doing my sworn duty.
Modesty is your prerogative, but know that cooperation and goodwill have been rarities of late. You do your Lord Tunon a great honor by aiding your cousins in the disfavored.
Thank you.
No, don't mind us while you trade your gushing praise. We're sure the Fatebinder has come because our company lacks in small talk.
I come bearing an edict of Kairos. Here we go.
Once again, you bring us support in a time of need. We fondly remember your service to the Chorus in the taking of the Bastard City. We knew back then you were destined for great things. But we had not anticipated you would be twice honored with the task of proclamation. So, do not keep us waiting. What is the Overlord's will?
Let's see. These are all the same things, of course, but they all have a different tone to them. This is actually kind of interesting because that lets me decide, like, how our character would actually speak. It seems you will need some encouragement to work together. Kairos' edict will end the lives of everyone in this valley unless the Ascension Hall is claimed by Kairos' Dais Swords. Sure. The earth sways with each word you utter, the air thickening with warmth as you pronounce the tersely phrased commandment. its every syllable drafted by the hands of Kairos. With the edict proclaimed, your pulse quickens and the muscles in your legs, worn from a long trip down the mountains, feel renewed. The tired limbs now nearly buoyant with vigor. Okay, interesting.
The Overlord means to compel us into action. No doubt the avalanches in the mountains are part of this ultimatum. We must conquer the Oathbreakers or die in failure. There is no room for error, and no other way out of this valley alive. We'll need to advance across the Mitanni. We lose everything if we stand still. And we move to back up Plan Green. The Earthshakers didn't make it over the mountain in time. So we do this the hard way. Over the walls, instead of through.
He taps a finger to his temple. A low rumble escapes from under his beard.
So, you found your backbone at last! Oh, we were worried past humiliations would make you soft. Timid. That was a record for you, right? A baker's dozen lost in one sortie. If you had waited for the chorus reinforcements, maybe we'd have eyes and ears on the matter.
The Archon of Secrets passes a scepter from one hand to the next, chuckling softly with each toss. By the way, this music is very weird for what's going on here. Like, it's actually pretty heroic, but like, what the hell? Okay. Let's let them go at it.
You make it sound like you've been putting even the slightest effort into getting a foothold across the Mitanni, when all you've done is set your gangs to uncoordinated raids. You're the Archon of Secrets. Why is it you still don't know the enemy's full strength and capabilities? Maybe you know and choose not to share.
Look, if you're afraid to send more troops against the Oathbreakers, just admit that you're a coward and allow us to take charge of the situation. The Scarlet Chorus will be happy to prove it can do what the disfavored cannot.
Okay.
I tire of your incessant heckling. The disfavored have shouldered the brunt of this war, and I will not have you mock our sacrifices.
My lord. Beric and his band have been drilled on the Echo Call assault plan. The Crescent Runner should be briefing him as we speak regarding the latest enemy's movements along the river. I will dispatch him at once, the Iron Marshal salutes, clapping her gauntlet to her breastplate. And I will ensure the Chorus stands ready to march. If the disfavored can take the river, then the chorus has the manpower to secure the outer ring of the valley.
Our soldiers clamor for battle, and at last we shall have it. Verse, we command you to continue guarding the Fatebinder. Tunon's Chosen is our honored guest, and must be shown our finest hospitality.
Okay.
I won't let you down, boss. She'll get through the campaign in one piece, as long as she doesn't do anything too stupid.
And, lest we forget, we owe you a debt, Stormcaller. Last year, our spies in Stalwart were falsely accused of siding with the locals. Had you not been there to weigh in, justice would no doubt have gone awry.
Oh, thank you. The Archon of Secrets tosses a small handful of rings your way as he begins to leave. He taps the fifth eye on the shoulder, and with one last twirl of his scepter, the Archon departs with his underling. Catch the rings. The Archon of Secrets lets out a small chuckle as he leaves. Hey, it's money. I don't know what your problem.
Finally, the fool and his puppet are gone. Perhaps now I can hear myself think. Rarely do I question Kairos's judgment, but I will never understand why the voices of Narat is given such authority. I shudder to think what will become of us all should Tunon favor him in the end. Though the edict threatens the Scarlet Chorus just as it threatens us, I cannot shake the feeling that our allies will work against us. You've shown your worth in war, and your name has been known to the Legion since the very beginning of this long conquest. So I'd ask that you join us this one last time. to help us wrap up this last objective. If you wish to be counted amongst the glorious, speak with the Iron Marshal. She will direct the order of battle until we are ready for the final push into the Citadel.
I'm short a few scouts, short a few soldiers, short a few everything. I'm sure my brethren would be grateful for the assistance of a skilled outsider. And what of the Scarlet Chorus? How will they be helping?
I ask myself that question often. While we take the river crossing, the Scarlet Chorus should be using their sizable presence to remove the Oathbreaker patrols lurking in the Outer Valley.
The Oathbreakers have maintained a sizable force outside the Citadel. We need the Chorus's manpower to scour the region. Otherwise, the Oathbreakers will attack our heels once we cross the Mitanni. I'd be honored to help, I guess. I'm not going to glare silently. The Iron Marshal salutes Graven Ash and then turns to leave the tent. I will be at the training grounds, ready the soldiers. Find me there when you are ready. And though I am loath to mention it, the Chorus can likely use your assistance. They certainly won't secure the outer side of the valley on their own. The Fifth Eye will be somewhere in that rat's nest they call Camp Due East. Seek him out if you must. Can we help both sides? Hello, Graven Ash. The first time you proclaimed an edict, you gave the enemy a suspicious amount of time to ready themselves. I chalk it up to excessive mercy for a backwards people, but when the edict is against your kin, that is an order you follow to the letter. May we speak a moment? I tire of this endless prattle. I am the Archon of War, and the Overlord has decreed battle. If you wish to help, go speak with my soldiers. Return when you have done something useful. Holy crap, his stats are ridiculous, of course. But he has high defense in basically everything.
Right.
Can we start stealing stuff again? This battle report comes from Echo Call Crossing, blames the failure of the assault on the village of the Scarlet Chorus. Apparently their scouts failed to report critical intelligence about the enemy's composition. Interesting. So we have 8 days till Kairos' Day of Swords, huh? Okay. This feels like a very long prologue, by the way. What's this bag holding, guy? A pungent odor emanates from the sack slung over the soldier's back. Wow, a whole stuff's going on here. Earthshaker, is that a class? I guess it is. Oh, that's part of the Earthshaker Guild. Okay, got it. So he says, what do you mean if you haven't heard from Commander Ironcore? It's been a full span since we sent word to him. Last we heard, Master Radix said to keep an eye on the northeastern pass, that he'd be coming through here. For the mercy of Kairos, we don't have the soldiers to send hunting through the streets for our own damned Earthshakers. Fatebinder Crendus, am I right? I'm Servius, commander and third generation disfavored. Specifically, I am Servius the Younger. Some folks can't keep track. The rank says commander, but lately I'm just organizing patrols and trying to stay out of the way. You should talk to the Iron Marshal if you've something official that needs discussing. What is it you need? I heard you asking the Earthshaker where the reinforcements have gone. Is there a problem? I'm afraid so. Radix, the head of the Earthshakers, is supposed to arrive with a group of his most competent spellslingers to help break the stalemate. I don't know what's holding their arrival, and that worries me. If you were at all inclined to lend a hand, we could use some arcane support on our side, rather. I could lend a hand, yes. Could you? I knew that Tudon's agent wouldn't fail us in a time of need. I'll mark the last known site of our Earthshaker reinforcements on your map. Good hunting, Fatebinder. Why do you think the siege has delayed so long? It should have been over real quick and simple. The first cohort arrived in the valley and went right in for the kill. But that was before we knew the Vendrian Guard had sages and Water Witch on their side, and that Water Witch on their side. A bigger problem is the Scarlet Chorus. They eagerly conscript the Vendrian Guard, but I have no proof of this. It seems they do very little to keep watchful eye on these drafted Tearsmen. They are often sent out on patrol, and we suspect that they use the opportunity to escape back to the Vendrian Guard. Every chorus conscript has a choice: life under Kairos or death under the army's boots. By all means, feel free to cut down those who choose the latter. We won't be offended. Just so we don't mistake each other, I know what I'm saying carries an implication of treachery. I'm not making a formal accusation before Tunant's agent. I'm just voicing my gut opinion on the matter. The two armies haven't worked well together in years. Why do you think that is? Come on, Minder. Seems like asking why beasts stink. This favorite are only too eager to deliver Kairos's peace to Tears. Well, the Scarlet Chorus bring only mayhem in their wake. You can tell me the voice of Narat has a plan, and I'll take your word for it. But the Chorus sure seem to blunder around, never moving with purpose as we do. I wonder if we've been fighting the same war, soldier. I've seen Ash yank his precious soldiers away from battles more than he's won. If you want to call that progress, be my guest. Unless we find a way to work as one, I fear that the Scarlet Chorus will step in front of Graven Ash's strategies at every turn. As far as I'm concerned, it seems like the voice of Rat is only here to amuse himself, while the rest of us are here to do our job. Tell me about yourself. Not much to tell. My father was Savius the Elder. My father was Savius the First of his name. Lead drill master of Ash's First Iron Guard, back when they were the Bronze Guard. I was born into the Legion, and with any hope, I'll die in the Legion. The rest you will hopefully hear when the storytellers immortalize me. He was in the Bronze Guard. So your family must have been with Ash since he was... Your family must have been with Ash since before he was with Kairos. Ah, you know your history. Savius nods with gusto. The blood goes back that far. Not the memories as I only ever knew my father. My grandfather was just a legend, one of Ash's best warriors back before the disfavored were reforged in iron. He shrugs. I'm proud of my heritage, but I try not to brag. There are folks who love the Legion every bit as much as I do, but they lack the same pedigree. You should be proud of your pedigree. Thanks, but I try not to think about it too fondly. If anything, every time I screw up something up, I wish I wasn't dragging the family name through the mud with me. Bronze Guard? Well, his day and age was a century ago, and they didn't have Kairos's modern luxuries like iron. So back then, the great general's inner council was known as the Bronze Guard. Is this all? Okay. So I think we take a bit of a break here. And then we'll pick up... I mean, we have a whole bunch of stuff that opened up here. Barrack, Iron Marshal, Aranos, and then the Scarlet Chorus too, so... we definitely have a lot of stuff to do. And in 8 days to do it too, so that'll be interesting. I guess we could actually fail this if there's an actual timer here, so that's interesting. That means we have to keep track of, like, how we spend our time traveling, because traveling takes up hours, literally hours. In any case, thanks for watching. This is Tyranny, and I will see everyone later.